Greetings everyone and welcome to the Let's Build series. This is going to be a series where I'm going to do a mix between building tutorials and also the sort of time-lapsey building over time sort of thing, where I'm going to be building a massive city eventually using the LexTube Let's Build mod pack. So here I am today in my new world. Now this is not a flatland world, it may look like it, but if we head north here and we can actually see on our map, if we look here, you'll start to see this. This is a river because I've actually built this inside of a world painter map that I've made. Now I'm not very good at world painter, this is a very basic build, but I've essentially made it like a very large flatland world that also includes rivers. It's all in a giant island and it also has beaches and all that sort of stuff. So I'm going to be using this map. I may change the map, but for now I think I'm going to be using this map. It seems big enough. And that's that. Now here is the road system. You can see that I've made the road system. I've inadvertently made a swastika. Don't worry, this isn't some sort of Nazi thing. I also realized that a swastika is related to Buddhism and peace and all that sort of stuff. Anyway, so this is the sort of like central intersection thing for a double lane, kind of like two-way road. This is sort of a highway intersection sort of thing. And then we go over here, we have the smaller roads that are kind of single, kind of like one way, one the other way, pretty simple. Whereas this is kind of like two lane going one way and two lane going the other way. So what I want to do is I just want to basically show you how to do some of these basic things. Now, all the only mod that I'm essentially using really is the Forge Multipart thing. And it works a little different to the old Red Power micro block system. And it's allowed me to make a lot more advanced and better looking stuff compared to before, which is great. It means we can now build stuff with more interesting things in it. I have used some extra mods. This is actually basalt from Project Red. This is the concrete from Railcraft as well, because I think they make for very good pavements and roads in the road system. So this is the extra mods that I'm using for this. And I think that is actually it. That seems to be the only three mods that I'm using for this section. Right, so let's go over here. What I've got myself is a block of quartz cover and also a basalt cover and a basalt nook. Now what I want to do here is I want to recreate this. This is a little kind of intersection. Now this is obviously for left-hand drive, left side of the road, right-hand drive cars, like it is in the UK where I come from. So I want to build this. Now as you can see here, you can see that this is all one block, but it contains multiple block colors, which is a very awesome thing indeed. Right, so we're gonna knock these two out here and I'm gonna knock these two out here. So what I wanna do is I wanna place these in like that. And you can see in the same way that Project Red, in the same way that Red Power works with the micro blocks, we have this sort of system where depending on where you look at on the block, depends on where it's gonna place it and so on. So I've placed that here. Now I wanna place it again and again to make it three thick. Like that. Then all I'm going to do is I'm going to get my basalt cover, go around to the other side of that same block and just place them in, making sure to click into that centerpiece like that. Because obviously if we click the end, it's going to work like that. And that's not what we want. We want to click in the centerpiece like that. And that creates these. Now that is a very cool effect indeed. So in fact, if we go over here, it wasn't that block. It was that block I wanted to take out. There we go. And we're going to place those again. One, two, three. One, two, three. Now what I've essentially done here is I've done something wrong. I'm going to still, again, do this thing for this bit, but we're going to leave the other two bits for a different thing. Because inside the same block, I now want to add these lines here like that. And again, I want to go over to this side. I want to make the same three block here, three block here, and I want to add these to the side here. Now, these are going to be like the center lines in the road, like we have over here. And as you can see, this is this bit here. Like that. Now, you may notice that we can't use basalt covers for this because of the way that it works. Obviously, you see that it's going to come out like that and it's going to get rid of that line, and that's not what we want. So this is why I have a basalt nook. It's a very small thing. It's a corner block, essentially. So I'm going to place that inside there and make a little corner. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to add to it each time, like that. And as you will see, as it expands that way, it doesn't cover the white. And it means that you can fill the block with the basalt without affecting any of the other blocks. Like that, again, we do that. Look at that. And again, we're going to do it on this side, like this, like that. All we just have to do is make sure that we click inside the block, not on top, because otherwise that happens. Like that. And there we go. So I'm just going to place the same again, get that basalt there. That's a very simple one because it's only on one side. So basically, if it's on one side, you can use this. If it's on multiple sides, you're going to be wanting to use the basalt nook. And there you go. There is a junction. So now for this bit, I'm going to do a line, and I'm also going to do the cat's eyes that you can see here. Now, these are made out of glowstone. Now, if we hit it over to night, you will see that they actually glow. They work as they are, you know, they work as intended. They work as cat's eyes in the road. Now, if you don't have cat's eyes in your country, they are essentially lights that go in the middle of the road so you can basically see all the different lanes. For example, when you go and drive in mainland Europe, I've noticed they don't have these in a lot of countries that I've driven in. And we've actually had it where it's been snowing before and you can't even see the lanes on the road anymore. Whereas in the UK, you can still see what you're doing. It's a lot better. You can still see where you're going. And in fact, at night in the UK, you can actually turn your headlights off and you can drive in this. I wouldn't advise this, but you can drive in the same lane. Like, you can see through the lights where the lanes are. They work as like the lines for the lanes. Obviously people won't be able to see you. I wouldn't suggest doing that. I imagine if you got caught, you would get pulled over and you would get a fine, but that is completely possible. So what I've just essentially done here, I did that very quickly. Let me start again. I've made these double thick. Obviously, instead of just doing one side, what that would mean is it would be uneven. It would mean this lane would be bigger than this lane. So we want to get these and place them on this side of each block. And again, all I'm going to do, it's very basic, just get in the basalt cover. And I'm going to build them up. Obviously, we have to kind of stand at a certain angle to see it all, like that. It kind of, the hardest bit is where we get to here, where we have to make sure that we look down, click in the middle, like that. And again, click in the middle, and in the middle. That's very simple, and that's how we do the lines. Now, this is going to be a bit more awkward for this bit. Let me just grab, if we go to here, and use the glowstone. Now, this isn't standard glowstone, you may notice. These are all the glowstones that we have from the Chisels mod. I'm a big fan of Chisels mod, and that is in the mod pack as well. All we have to do is we need to get ourselves this one, which is the neon glowstone, and I want to grab myself a neon glowstone nook. There we go, neon glowstone nook, like that. Right, so I'm going to place that block down here. This is just going to make it easier. We want to place them on the corners, on the inside of these blocks, not on top. We want to place them inside these blocks here. We're going to take that one out and place in another one. And that's going to be a little cat's eyes. Obviously, if we go to nighttime again, you can see that it glows and stuff and does that its job as it's supposed to. Right, let's turn that back to day. So what I'm going to do for this one is very different. We're going to be using the nook again. We can't use the lines. Now, if we try and use the lines, we'll see what happens here. We get to here and we can't do anything else. And obviously, we can't place anything else here. And we've got a gap, which we don't want. So we're going to place in a nook like this, and we're going to fill it up to as much as we can get the nook, and we're going to do that on each corner like this. And what we're going to be left with, if we do this correctly, is we should have these thick kind of gaps here. So I'm just going to fill this up, fill this up, fill this up, and there we go, we've got our gaps. Now you can see that we've got this block here. We can place more blocks in these corners because these corners are obviously free. So we're going to place them in each corner like that. Now, here's the fun bit. All we have to do is do the same thing again, but as you'll notice, it's still building this corner up, but it's not affecting anything else. So we're going to get to that. That's going to build that corner. That's going to build that corner. And we basically just have to do that for each bit like this. Now, this is obviously where it's long-winded. Trying to do this for a long stretch of road is going to be a massive pain, but obviously, what I'm essentially doing is I've made all these kind of things here, and I'm going to jump into MC Edit, I'm going to copy, I'm going to paste them, I'm going to repeat them, and it essentially means that I don't have to do this each time, because just doing this lot here took me 5 hours, and it took me the whole weekend just to kind of plan everything out and kind of like trial with a bunch of different ideas. So there we go. These are the little cat's eyes, these are the lines, and these are the junctions here. So that's very good. Now this is going to work a bit differently. Now in these lanes here, obviously we want to add in these lines. I'm not going to do those because it's very long-winded, you've already seen it. What I want to show you how to do is this little bit in the middle here. Now, you don't have to use yellow. You can use the same quartz as you have before, but I wanted to have yellow centers to kind of like differentiate between the white quartz lines and obviously the center point. So I'm going to, basically, I've got my button to pick a block by looking at it, which is this. I've actually got it bind to my middle mouse button. I'm just going to clear this all out here. I'm going to grab this, which is a basalt post, which we can either place on the edge or, if we look in the middle, we can place it in the middle. And if we click on it again, we can make it bigger and bigger and bigger. And we can also have it like this, where we can have the multiple on each side, like that. That's another little technique if you wanted to make something that was slightly less like that, like a cube, but with rounded edges. You can do that. Right, so I'm going to grab that, and I'm going to grab these, which are giant yellow flower covers. Now, this is actually from the Biomes Are Plenty mod from the flower biome. If we just go to flower here, you will see that we have these. We have giant flower stem and the red flower and the yellow flower. So I'm using that because it's quite a simple texture. It's not too textured. It's not something like gold where they have a lot of details in them. It's nothing like glowstone. We don't want it to glow. And we don't want, if we just go to yellow, we do have some yellow stuff, but they're not the same sort of shade. Obviously, wall has that sort of wall texture that we all know. So I've gone for this one. Obviously, it depends where you're building this. Obviously, this whole thing is going to be built for the LexTube Let's Build mod pack. If you're not using that mod pack, you may not be able to build the things that I'm building here. Right, so I'm going to grab that. And actually, I'm going to grab these things and teach you how to do the pavements as well. Right. So we got this, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here. Now, very simply, what you want to start with is just by going through. A very good technique, if you're going to be doing this for a long way, is to kind of do it from this way. Because obviously, if you get this lined up perfectly, you can just do this, and you can build them for a long time. So that's something that I'd suggest doing first on both sides, like that. That's one of my techniques for kind of like quickly building in these sort of blocks, because they are very difficult to build with. So now that we've got this, obviously what I just did there was I did that. If you hold shift, it means you can then, instead of, if you click again, it'll make it bigger. If you hold shift and click, you'll be able to get it from a different direction. So I've got that. Now I'm just going to add it to the end each time and get that. All I want to do is just click on them to fill up the block. Now it's going to be slightly lower, but I don't think that matters. I think that's as part of the style. Now what I've got here is fancy glowstone lantern, and I've got it as a post, and that's because this texture perfectly has this sort of light in the middle with the wooden edges, and I think this works perfectly for separate cat's eyes to go in the center here. So instead of having these cat's eyes on these double lane roads, we have just these lights in the middle here. Now what you can do as well, if I go over to here, I've got these extra things here where we can build. It's just a nice little extra. So we're going to grab the leaf and we're going to grab this little post. This is a metal plate with almost no rust on it strip, which is a very long name. So we're going to go over here. We're going to get our oak leaves and we're just going to place them on top. There is going to be a gap, but you're not going to notice the gap. It's not going to matter. When you're looking at it from the outside, we're going to see it like this. And you could leave it like that with a hedge in the middle. That's fine. Or we get this. I'm going to place them on the top. And I'm going to place them on the sides of each block like that. And that is going to count for the railings. And that's how we do railings and hedges and stuff like that in having a sort of highway road system. And that's pretty much that. Right, moving over here. I was going to show you how to do the pavement. I've got a block of concrete cover. Very simple block. Another technique you can use to build this quickly is to always make sure you're clicking on the side like that. And obviously, we can do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Obviously, you can build it quicker. That was me rushing. I didn't mean to do that. So that's how we do that kind of raised bit there. And all I want to do on the edges is I want to grab a block of concrete post. Obviously, we could stick that in the middle. That's not what we want. That's not what we want. We want to click on the side like that. And that makes the curb. Just a nice little basic extra detail there for the curb on the pavement. Right, last thing I'm going to show you. This works in the same way. This is for these corner blocks here. Obviously, because we've got, let me just grab this. You can see this is all in one block here. I've got these on two sides. These are covers. And then I've used a block, a little nook like that. And I've just placed them and got bigger and bigger until it fills the block. These ones are very simple. Again, just covers. Covers on the other side like that. And just building them out like that. And that's how I've got this massive square for the intersection. Very simple again. I've used the same thing, but I've used concrete covers just to make little walkways for the crossings. This is what I want to do quickly. I just want to show you how to make these. So let me grab this. Let me grab this. This. And also we're going to grab these like that. What else have we got here? We got that. We'll have to go back for the rest. Right. So I'm going to build this up here. I'm going to build this from the middle. We're going to go one, and I'm going to add this. This is going to be the control blocks, the control block. If we go to gold, actually, I'm going to grab myself a gold post rather than a gold pillar. Gold post, there we go. and we build it like that. We can still use the same thing. I didn't like how it was just kind of blending in with the same thickness, so I made it bigger, but I have actually had one of you on Facebook. By the way, I link all the pictures of the stuff that I build on Facebook prior to the videos, so if you want to go and follow me on Facebook, also Twitter as well, obviously you can get kind of advanced, kind of like seeing things before everyone else on the videos. Someone said that this looked too big, but I don't think it does. I think it looks pretty fine. So we're going to build that up. Now we've got another block gap, and then we got this one, which is where we're going to build basalt there, basalt there. And then we want that with another pillar. Let's build this with a post outwards like that. These are going to be the don't walk signs. Obviously, it takes a bit of imagination, but that's just the beauty of Minecraft. So we're going to build that up a bit further. Again, we're going to go up. How many are we going to go up here? 2, 3. Obviously, this is going to be one less than that one, so that should be fine. I'm going to make that one thicker. Again, basalt posts. Again, like that. In fact, if we're going, that's going in the opposite direction, isn't it? So if we're building it that way, what side have we got there? Oh, okay, we're copying this one. Right. So we're going to pop that one there. And I'm going to make those thicker. Like that. It's just kind of, it just makes it look nicer, I think. So we're going to go 2 along, and then we're going to go another 3, and those 3 are going to be made thicker like that. Now inside, I'm going to make the lights. So we've got red, we've got yellow, we've got emerald, like that. Now you could leave it like that, but for some reason emerald seems to go above the basalt, don't know why, which is why I decided to go along and make kind of this casing inside here, which I'm just using a basalt panel for. Just going along, it's all in the same block, that is all inside one massive block. If I just grab a piece of grass here, you can see, look, there's one block, there's everything, it's all in one block. What else did we have in here? Oh yeah, I also had the glowstone. Again, I used the same neon glowstone nook that I use for the cat's eyes, and I just place them like there, like that. And that's just so that it's just an extra design feature. But again, if we go to nighttime, it makes them glow. Now, you can actually have glowstone in the middle if you wanted, but I couldn't find a glowstone texture that perhaps matched. So for that, for the red one, I used giant red flower. For this one, I used giant yellow flower. And for this one, I used smooth emerald just to get the red, yellow, and green. And that's how I've made these lights here. And I think that's pretty much it. I've covered how to do the centers, how to do the lines, how to do the junctions, how to do the cat's eyes, and how to do the traffic lights. I think that's it. I think that's it. So there we go. That is it for the first episode of Let's Build. They aren't all going to be tutorials. They are going to be kind of like me building over a long period of time with some cinematic things. I haven't actually. I forgot to do that for that block. Let's quickly do that then. Let's just do that. That's some more Let's Build stuff. Like that, build them across, and on the other side, build them across. I better go and check that out, actually. Just to quickly show you for the corners, very, very simple. On the inside corner, all you have to do is just add them, like that, and that. And for the outside corners, we have to grab an extra block of concrete corner. I'm just going to go like that. So in one block, we have that. In one block, we have that. Obviously, that would leave us with a gap, but we fill that with that, and that gives us the corner. So that's going to be it. I don't know what I'm going to be building next, but I've got a massive list of things that I want to build. Between now and the next episode, I am likely going to be rebuilding the road system and deciding how big I want the plots of land. So next time we jump in, this will be all roadworks, all road systems rather, instead of roadworks. But that's going to be it for this video. There are loads more details that I can do with the road system, but I'm just going to leave it here for this video, and maybe I'll cover that in a later video. So thank you guys very much for watching. This is obviously the first episode of this series. If you want to click like to let me know that you're enjoying it, I will be doing actual proper builds, sort of like houses, buildings, shops, cinemas, supermarkets, loads of things. Also, again, loads more details on the roads, car parks, road works, all those sorts of things. They will be coming in future videos. So thank you guys very much for watching. I'm sure I've said that a million times already. And goodbye.